Hi, my name is Paul Morris, and I'm director of Earth Connection Center, a biological reserve in the Yucatan jungle. It's a 100-acre property, and on that we have a huge diversity of different wildlife, birds and insects and iguanas and all sorts of different species. And it's really an amazing place. We also have a beautiful cenote, which is a hole that goes into the ground where the groundwater is, with beautiful crystal clear water. So because of that cenote, a lot of different species come to that property to get water, because there is no groundwater and no lakes, no rivers in the Yucatan. So this area is a high biodiversity spot, and we are encouraging the restoration of the different plants on the property, planting plants, growing trees. We're doing all sorts of things to enhance the biodiversity of the property. We're looking for students. We want to do biological research on biodiversity. We've had students in the past who worked on ant biodiversity and bee biodiversity, but also we need people to look at plant diversity and all sorts of things that occur. There's so many different species that are very unique to the Yucatan Peninsula, many species that haven't even been discovered yet. So it's really truly an amazing place. In 2014, I took my truck and I took on a journey. So I went through the U.S. and then I started journeying through Mexico, and I ended up in the Yucatan Peninsula. So we brought a property down there we created a biological reserve. And as you can see, we're located close to Merida, and the property is about 100 acres, 40 hectares. And it's got a whole diversity of different species on it. So this is our team. I'm a restoration ecologist. Adi is an agronomist. And Juan is a naval engineer. Mexico is a mega diverse country, and the Yucatan Peninsula is extremely rich in diversity and endemic species. It's also on a flyway from North America into South America. So it's an extremely important area for biological diversity. So this is one of the reasons that we're doing this reserve right here. So in the beginning, this is what we found. It was very dry, very little vegetation. It was a former ranch. And so the cows that were on the property had basically denuded all the vegetation and eaten them. So in the dry season, anything green and anything that they can reach, they eat. And what we found was mostly shrubby trees, thorny shrubs. And so the area didn't have very much diversity on the ground, so we needed to do a lot of restoration work. So as a restoration ecologist, when we first came there, the land was very degraded. A lot of thorny trees and shrubs were still there because that's the only thing the cows wouldn't eat. So we needed to regenerate the soil and start growing the plants. So we collected a lot of different seeds, and we started growing different plants so that we could plant them out. We also created a little nursery to establish the plants. And as you can see, this was the casita when we first arrived. The cows were actually running in and out of that, so we had to repair it. There was no water on the property, so we had to hand haul up from the well that was established on the property. There was no electricity, different things like that. So there's all sorts of different challenges we had to face and overcome when we were starting out. As you can see, the area is very degraded. There's not a lot of ground cover. The trees are actually quite short, and so we had to grow those up. And you can see one of the tents in the background. You can see right through to it. And the aerial photo was a drone footage that we took about 2 years later. And you can see some of the trees are starting to grow up a little bit more. The garden's starting to take shape, and the tank is fixed. Most of the jungle in that area is actually very tall and very thick and very rich in diversity. In the first 2 years was very hard work. We invited all sorts of international volunteers to the property, and they helped us plant trees and establishing different infrastructure, establishing gardens, establishing the food forest. So we really appreciate all the help that we got from in the first few years. Later on, we started getting institutions involved, and we had university students coming and doing their research on the property. So we're continuing to do that, and we'll be bringing in more research into the property. We'll be getting students to study biodiversity, ecological restoration, and ecological agriculture techniques. So by year three, we had enough infrastructure in place. We started to do all sorts of different courses, and we started offering ecotourism. And so just bringing people in and teaching people about the different ecological processes and ecological restoration, as well as doing ecosystem restoration camps, so bringing people out to plant the trees, to restore the jungle, and to accelerate the process of restoring it back into a natural habitat. And here you can see that the property, this is year four, and things are really starting to green up. The trees are starting to jump up. The trees we planted are starting to grow. They're over 2-3 meters tall. And the jungle is really starting to fill in. And more bird species are starting to arrive. And it's really developing into a unique jungle experience. And as the vegetation started returning, because we're adding so much diversity of different native species into the forest ecosystem, we also saw the animals starting to return. So we have more and more species are coming in because we have such a diversity of different species that we've planted. And you know, one of the unique things that we came back was one of the anteaters. You can see him climbing down the tree there. And it's like when we found him coming, then this is like a species that didn't occur here before. And so we're starting to allow other species that didn't occur here because the cows had eaten all the vegetation and degraded the landscape. We're allowing the place to regenerate, and all the species are coming back. The animals originally, they would stay away from us. And so, you know, they're very wary. But then as we've been living there for years, gradually they're coming closer and closer. And, you know, you walk out the door and suddenly they're just like, oh, it's them. Okay, keep eating. So you gradually have this, you're integrated. You become part of their ecosystem and they see, okay, you're protecting them. You're not a threat. We're not going to hunt them. We're not going to kill them. So they see you as more benign, and you get more and more interactions with the creatures in the jungle. And it's really a special experience, you know, when a deer walks close by you, when the coatis walk across the trail in front of you, when the turkeys are coming out and drinking water while you're having tea in the morning. Just different things like that. Just having that experience, it's a moment, it stops your mind, and you're just there with the animal, totally present, totally in the moment, and yeah, it's beautiful. One of the unique features of the property is it has a cenote. All of the Yucatan, none of the water is actually on the surface. It's actually all below ground. So the animals have a really hard time getting water. So having the cenote there allowed for a lot of different bird species to come, and they'd come and get a drink of water. And one of the conditions that we changed on the property was creating a lot of little wet ponds. So we feed the water into even just a little bowl of water and put that out into on the ground, and all sorts of birds. And then we're getting all sorts of different insects and all sorts of different animals are starting to come. And so because we had great success with our first just putting a little bowl of water out, because a lot of these species can't even get down into the cenote. It's like 10 meter drop into the cenote. They can't climb down, then they're not getting water. So by just introducing different water features, and we'll talk about that in another video, we have so much more diversity of different species have come because of they're attracted to the water source. There's over 1,000 species of trees native to the Yucatan Peninsula. And one of the reasons that we really enjoy this area is because we can do a lot of carbon sequestration work in the area. The tropical trees grow so quickly. Within a few years that you're re-establishing a forest, whereas in the temperate region, it's much slower process. So we can pull down a lot of carbon and put it into the vegetative matter and put it into the soil, into the living tissues of the plants, and sequester a lot of carbon. We have over 500 different herbaceous plant species on the property. So there's each one of those species is unique, and so you have unique pollinators that pollinate only that plant. So the more different species that you have and the greater diversity of species of plants, you're also increasing the greater diversity of insects, birds, mammals. So you're increasing the diversity of the entire ecosystem. Usually I try to do a ground up restoration, so planting the plants and then allowing the other species to come in on their own. They find it. They find the natural habitats. So there really is a lot of endemic species within the Yucatan because it's such a unique habitat. The cenotes are one example. We have five different crayfish species. They're blind. They live at the bottom of the cenote. We have different fish species down there, an eel. So, I mean, all these species are blind and they're endemic and they're endangered and they're inside the cenote that's on our property. So that's just one example of all the different species that are occurring on the property and that are coming to the property. They're all very unique. It's really important that the jungle is healthy. The species all over the world are in decline. So many species, we're losing so many. So much biodiversity is being lost on the planet right now, and it's really a crime. It's all these species are disappearing. You know, it just grabs you by the heart when you realize how many species are disappearing. So it's really important to reestablish natural ecosystems. You can see the property that we have, the ecosystem was completely degraded, and slowly, step by step, with a lot of effort, we can start restoring the planet. So it's really important to have all these different ecosystems. I mean, it's only 100 acres, but that is basically a model. Showing other people how to do this, teaching people how to restore the land, how to live sustainably, how to grow food sustainably. But it's also an example that we want to repeat again and again and again, working with the Mayan farmers, working with the different landowners, and showing them how they can improve the property. We want to live in a tropical paradise. We want to live in a paradise that everybody can enjoy, not just humans, but all the wildlife that's around us. They all deserve to have a place to live as well. Well, we hope to inspire you, to show you different techniques that we're using, and to inspire you to do your own projects. So we're gonna be giving different videos that show different techniques that we're using and different processes and how we're doing it so that it's the least impact on the jungle, both here and in Canada, different projects that we're working on, and to share in the processes. You know, we've got processes for water, processes for cooking, process for getting the energy so that we can talk to you, different things like that. So please join us on our journey.